Hey everyone, it's Kato, and in this video, we're going to be talking about some more information that has come out about the new update that just released. So if you're interested in content like this and you want to see more in the future, I'd appreciate if you'd like and subscribe, but let's get right into it. So just a heads up, this video will contain potential spoilers for items that they did not mention in the recent tweet and blog post about the new update that came out. So I just want to throw that out there before we get started here. But there is actually a lot to talk about here because some data mines have been done. People have gone through and found all of the items that released in this update, and it is actually a lot more than we originally expected. So shout out to Animal Crossing World. I will have a link to their article down in the description of the video. They put together all of the items that came with this new update. So I'm going to be talking about those today. Starting off, we're going to talk about all of the different food items. And these are the handheld food items that you're going to get from Red during the fireworks show. And these are so cute. I'm even more excited about these now that I'm seeing all of the different color customizations. There are 5 different versions of the boba tea. You've got boba coffee, boba green tea, mango tea, milk tea, and strawberry tea. Honestly, I love all of them. I think the look of the coffee and green tea is probably my favorite, but they are all absolutely adorable. There are 3 different frozen treats. You have the chocolate, orange, and Remune soda, which I have never heard of that before, so I'm not really sure what that is. Similarly, you have that flavor in the cotton candy, but you also have melon, plain, and strawberry. Again, I love these. I love the pastel colors. Obviously, it's cotton candy, so they didn't stray too far from just what cotton candy looks like, but both of these are absolutely adorable. Cotton candy, frozen treats, love all of them. And it's honestly more versions than I anticipated, so I really, really like that. Next up, let's talk about the items that are coming to Nook Shopping for the different seasonal events. Several of these are ones that we already saw, including the mooncakes, dango, cucumber horse, and eggplant cow. However, there are some different ones in here that we didn't see in the blog post. The marigold decoration, which is stunning. And the other one, I cannot pronounce it. If someone can help me with the pronunciation, that would be amazing. But it translates to 1,000-year candy. So it's a little pack of candies, which is so, so cute. It is actually a long, thin red and white candy, which symbolizes healthy growth and longevity. I'm seriously loving all of these seasonal cultural items and just learning more about these different festivals and holidays. It's really amazing. Moving on to the next set of items, Songpyeon was included in this, but also look at these handheld lanterns. These are stunning. I'm so curious to see what these look like in game, especially the leaves and geese. I think they're so adorable. Obviously, it says handheld, so I'm assuming they're going to be small and your character's going to hold them, but still, that is so cute. I absolutely love them. I want to get all of these. So far, so many items that have not been included in what we've seen for the update. Now, next up, this is going to be the super spoiler section. So if you don't want to see it, go ahead and click away. But there are also some Halloween items that have been included in this update. I don't know if it was by accident or intentional, but it looks like 3 new items are included in this update if you want to time travel to get them. The spooky treats basket, the spooky tree, and the spooky trick lamp, all of which come in 4 different customization options, just like all of the Halloween items last year. It comes in the orange, yellow, green, and white. I like the fact that they match the same colors as the ones last year, and it makes sense because those are the colors of pumpkins that we already have. I am a little bit upset that this is coming out now because it just makes me feel like we're not going to have anything else coming in October as far as the items go. Hopefully I'm wrong in that and these 3 just managed to slip through somehow and we're going to be getting more. because surely it's not just three items for Halloween. Obviously, I think we'll get something when we complete the Halloween event like we did last year. I can't remember, though, exactly how many Halloween items they offered last year. I feel like there were several. There were several different recipes, so I wonder if they'll do recipes again in addition to these three items that got released. I don't know, but these are the ones that came through. They're all really cute. The treats basket, you walk around and you hold it. I haven't time traveled forward to get any of the items. I don't know if I will actually time travel forward to get them. I might ask a friend for a few of them just so I can see what they look like in person, but I don't want to go all the way forward to the event, so I'm just going to look at the pictures for now, but they are really cute. I'm curious to see what the spooky trick lamp does when you open it, I guess. Although it's a little bit similar to the spooky lantern from last year. I don't know how I feel about that. I don't feel like any of these three items are like game-changing items. Also, just want to apologize for the amount of times that I've said cute in this video, but I'm just really excited about all these items. I do wish we were getting less handheld items. I think the handheld items are cute, they're fun to carry around, fun to take pictures with them. They're just not as useful when it comes to decorating your island. Some of them look okay when they're placed down, but then a lot of them, just the perspective of them is off because they're so tiny, and then other things in the game are so large. It can just look off when you place them. I have seen other people placing things like the cotton candy and the boba drink, and they actually look pretty decent, but I feel like some of the other stuff, the lanterns are probably going to be really tiny. The spooky treats basket I envision is going to be very small. So one minor complaint, everything else, adorable, 10 out of 10. I love it. That's just kind of my thoughts on the handheld stuff. So I don't know. What do you think? Do you like these Halloween items? What do you think about all of the other items? I'm actually more interested in the other stuff than the spooky stuff right now. But I don't know. Definitely let me know what you think down in the comments. Do you think this was on purpose? Do you think it was an accident? Do you like all of the items? None of the items?